we never fail. Your word we come to pass. Your word must surely stand. 'Cause you are God, you're not a man.
Yuko Mungu mbinguni asikiaye maombi yetu. Tunapoomba asikia, anajibu. Tunapoomba asikia maombi yetu.
Solitude moments with the Lord.
Amen.
Solitude moments with the Lord is our message. Part 2 comes to you today, and we are believing God that Amen. It's going to be a wonderful, wonderful time. Amen. John chapter 6, verse 14. Then those men, when they had seen the miracles that Jesus did say, this is of a truth that prophet that should come into the world. Amen. For sure, this is a prophet that should come into the world. Jesus Christ. There is no contradiction, no argument about that. Jesus is the prophet that must come in the world.
Amen.
Verses 15, then Jesus perceived that they were come and taken by force to make him a king, he departed again into the mountain himself alone. And we believe he went to the mountain to pray. When he perceived they wanted to take him and make him a king by force. They wanted Jesus to be their king by force.
Yes.
When you see a good man, he wants him to be your king. They were trying to do something noble, something good, these men. They were not ill-motived. They did not have ulterior motives about making Jesus their king. Praise God.
Amen.
They saw a good man and they decided to make him their king.
Amen.
When you see a good man of God, you make him your king.
Yes.
When you see a pastor that is anointed, that is working with God, that God is using mighty, you make him your king. Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We don't choose the bad people, we choose the right people. These people did not have any problem about what they were deciding to do. They wanted him to keep ruling them. Because he's a miracle worker. We make a miracle worker, promise keeper, right in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. When they saw Jesus was a nice waymaker, a nice promise keeper, they wanted to make him the king of their lives forever and by force.
My God.
You need to make Jesus your king forever by force.
Amen.
Yeah, Jesus, from now henceforth, you will be my king.
Amen.
Lift up your hands and say, Jesus, you are my king.
Jesus, you are my king.
I want to hear your voice and say, Jesus, you are my king.
Jesus, you are my king.
Yeah, let him rule over your life.
Amen.
Let him rule over your lives.
Uh-huh.
Only that the time for him to be their king and not come.
Uh-huh.
So Jesus perceived that they wanted to make him their king by force. He withdrew himself and went into the solitary place. Verse 16, and when evening was come now, his disciples went down into the sea and entered into a ship and went over the sea to one Capernaum. And it was now dark when Jesus was not come unto them. Verses 18, and the sea arose by reason of great wind that blew. Verses 18, verses 19. So when they had rowed about 25 or 30 furlongs, they see Jesus walking on the sea and drawing nigh unto the ship, and they were afraid. But he said unto them, Is it I? Be not afraid. Then they willingly received him into the ship, and immediately the ship was at the land whither they went. They saw Jesus coming to them at night.
Yes.
After Jesus spent his time in the solitude place, the Bible says they were now about 25 or 30 furlongs. That's about several meters from the land. So there is no way they could come back. They were at the middle of the lake and there were storms. Jesus, realizing that they were in a storm, he came walking on the water.
Amen.
He came walking on the water. He came walking on the water.
Yes.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He came walking on the water.
Amen.
And they saw him and they were afraid that this man, they have never seen such a thing before. May I submit to you that the world is about to see things they have never seen.
Amen.
They have seen miracles, they have seen Jesus doing miracles, they have seen Jesus doing wonders, but there is an anointing for this generation.
Amen.
There is an anointing for this generation.
Yes.
That is not going to be shaken.
Amen.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are not going to be quiet on social media. We're going to tell them the truth.
Amen.
The truth we know cannot set them free unless we tell it to them. How many people here know something? How many people here have a truth they know about Jesus? Lift up your hand. Yeah. That is the truth you need to tell people.
What?
That is the truth you need to tell people. I'm sure that people are afraid of witches. We cannot be afraid of witches anymore.
Amen.
We want to fear God. When you fear God, witches fear you. Oh! When you fear God, witches fear you.
Yes.
Yeah. The only man the devil fears most is the man that has deliberately decided to lay down his life. That's the man the devil fears most. Not the man that has many cars. When you lay down your life, the devil begins to fear you. We must rise and ascend to rebels where the devil fears us.
Wow.
So Jesus came at night walking on the water.
Amen.
The same problem that was bothering them is the same problem Jesus kept on. Do you know that Jesus, no, Moses had to make a way to cross the Red Sea?
Amen.
For Moses to cross the Red Sea, he had to make a way. Who else knows the waters? Joshua. For Joshua to cross the waters, he had to make a way. There had to be a way over Jordan for Joshua to pass. When Elijah crossed, he hit the water. There was dry ground. So he passed on the water on a dry ground. When Elijah was coming back, he went through the same Jordan, but he had to hit it to stop and make a way. But when Jesus came, he does not have to eat the water. He does not have to make a way. He is the waymaker himself. He walked on the water. There was no prophetic ministration of making the way over the waters. Jesus walked on the waters. He never made a bridge.
Amen.
He walked on the water. He was the bridge himself. Which bridge? He's the one that bridges us to the Father.
Amen.
He's the bridge that we connect to get to the Father.
Amen.
A sinful man, a holy God, can only be bridged by Jesus.
Amen.
So when we have Jesus, we are not guilty of what we have done in the past.
Amen.
Our sins become null and void when we have Jesus. Are you getting what I'm saying?
Amen.
Your sins will not matter provided you repent them.
Amen.
Your wickedness before God is something you can take away today.
Yes.
So Jesus did not make a way in the waters. He stepped on the waters and walked, for he is himself the way. I am the way, the truth,
Amen.
And the life.
Amen.
That is your Jesus.
Amen.
That is my Jesus. That is our Jesus. He is a way maker.
Amen.
So he came walking on the waters. And his disciples were afraid. Jesus looked at them and said, "It is I. Do not be afraid. Fear not."
this, it is the Lord. Fear not.
Amen.
You are fearing now. After this, what is going to happen? After this, what is going to happen? After this, what is going to happen? It is the Lord. Fear not. It is I, the Lord. Fear not, Peter. And Peter was relaxed when he learned it was the Lord. And the Bible says that Jesus entered into the ship and immediately it landed in the shore. That's the miracles of Jesus.
Wow.
When he enters your ship, immediately it relaxes.
Amen.
It gets where you are going.
Amen.
Where you are going round and round looking for help, looking for help and shouting and fearing and screaming. Immediately he enters your boat, it will land in the shore. Give him a chance. Give him a chance. Give him a chance. Give him a chance. It will land in the shore when he enters, not when you are home. In the balance, I say, Jesus, I welcome you.
Jesus, I
welcome
you.
Jesus, I welcome you. Say, Jesus, I welcome you. Amen. Holy Spirit, thou art welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, thou art welcome in this place. Omnipotent Father, oh mercy and grace, thou art welcome in this place. And so he entered the ship and he landed where they were going. Peter never cried again. When Jesus is in the boat, you can never cry. Relax, let God work for you. Tell your neighbor, relax.
Relax.
Let God work for you.
Let God work for you.
Tell them again, relax.
Relax.
Let God work for you.
Let God work for you.
Tell your neighbor, you think that it is going to be messed up, it is not going to be messed up.
Amen.
Relax, let God work for you.
Amen.
Now, solitude moments, the alone moments. So when Jesus was praying, what was happening? We don't just go to the solitude prayer and then nothing is happening. There is a reason why God wants you alone to pray, to be with him, to speak to him.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
When Jesus mentions your name, when Jesus calls you to be with him, there is a reason for that.
Amen.
And you are going to see it today. Jesus spent the whole night, the whole many hours praying. Over 6 hours we see him praying here.
Yes.
We read from another Bible, it was around 3 a.m. when Jesus came. He prayed over 9 hours. So he was packed. He was full. He was alone for 6 hours with God. 6 hours with God alone.
My God.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do you know why the devil cannot bring us down? It's because we know how to spend time with God.
Amen.
It is very easy for you to bring the devil down if you will spend solitary times with God.
Amen.
Racy, four reasons or four things that happen to you when you spend time with the Lord in solitude. Praise God. Hallelujah. Four things that happen when you spend time with the Lord in the solitude. Number one, you are able to discern and overcome distractions. You are able to discern and overcome distractions. Look at Jesus. They want to make him a king. They are trying to tell Jesus, stop being a savior. Stop being a deliverer. Stop walking around. Hey, praise God.
Amen.
Stop suffering. Stop paying the price. Yeah, stop what you are doing. You are the Son of God. Can't you understand you are the Son of God? That is a deception of the enemy. Have you been deceived like that before?
Uh-huh.
The devil tells you, you are too good to go through this.
Right.
You are too qualified. Why are you going through some of these things? You are too qualified. That is what they are telling him. They want to make him a king. Stop prepaying the price. You are paying a lot of price. You are suffering a lot. You are the Son of God. Why are you suffering like this? Man of God, why are you going through a very difficult time? Jesus, come and become a king. Come and sit on the throne. We are going to give you our vote. So, Lakashinda, my God.
We are tired of the people that are our kings right now. We want to make you our king. Stop suffering. Stop walking on food, man of God, Jesus. Why are you walking? We want to give you a privilege. We want to give you a benefit. We want to give you an advantage. We'll put you in an advantaged position.
A prestigious.
Yeah. Can you move away from ghetto? Jesus, why are you looking for a place to live? You should be in palace. Can you give us permission? We remove Herod and place you there. You are the best. Be careful about people who tell you you are the best. Oh, you look good. Wow, I love your beauty. Young girl, my girl, oh yeah. I love your hips now. You look nice. Oh. Be careful about them. They are flattering you to finish you.
What?
And the worst of distractions are the good ones. Do you know they are good distractions? They are not telling Jesus, Jesus, we reject you, we don't like you, run away and move away from here. No. They are coming with good distraction. Good distraction. Good distraction. Yeah. They want to make you a minister in Zimmerman? What about giving you a job? You are suffering a lot, eh? You are suffering a lot. Can we give you a job? How much are you paying? Are you earning now? We are going to give you 4 times so that you can come and be our supervisor in Mombasa. And you come here to ask me, man of God, what do you think, Dad? What do you think? Is this from God? A good distraction is the worst. When the devil distracts you in a good way. You may not think it is the devil, you think it is God.
Yeah.
The worst of distractions is a good one. Not a bad one. When it becomes a good distraction, it can mess you around. Now, they wanted to make Jesus a king by force. Who would not want to be a king? Who would not want to be a king? Would you want to be a king? Would you want a position that is higher? That is what they were giving Jesus by force. And Jesus, instead of taking it, he went to pray. And he prayed that night. Therefore, when you pray in the solitary place, you are able to discern and overcome distractions. Distractions. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. For you and I, being effortlessly made king, would be the greatest opportunity in our lives. For Jesus to identify that it was not the perfect will of God, he went around in the mountain to get the stamina to turn the offer down.
What?
He had to pray to say no. There are some things you can't say no. You need the grace to say no. You need the grace to say no. My God. Let me tell you, those who are not married, you need the grace to say no to some things. Si rahisi kukataa kijana ambaye anataka kununulia kukulipia rent. Si rahisi kukataa. It is not easy to say no. Some things require you to have stamina to say no. Tell your husband, say, Lord, give me the stamina to say no.
Lord, give me the stamina.
Jesus needed the stamina to say no.
Amen.
To say no. You need power to say no to some things.
Amen.
It's not a joke.
Amen.
Yeah. When someone wants to buy you a house, when somebody wants to buy you a car, when somebody wants to keep you just like a side chick somewhere, you pass between God and him. And it does not make sense. Man, huyu Mungu wako hakupei nyumba na hakupei gari, lakini huyu mwanadamu mwingine anakupea. Unachagua. You try to choose, and it is very possible. It is very easy for you to fall in the wrong direction. You need the grace to say, no! If that person say, God, give me the grace to say no. This message may not be for everyone, but at least one or two people, wakisaidika, message itakuwa imefika nyumbani, and I will be very happy.
Amen.
I do cannot be preaching to all of you. I may be preaching to one person, or two people, or three people. The rest I don't know. Just one man. If Jesus will help one man through this message, I am comfortable and I am happy. If our message can save one man, is this enough?
You're right.
We don't have to save 100 people, thousands of people. If God will give us that opportunity, well and good. But for now, whoever is receiving this message and it changes him or her, if that person is one, I am okay. I am comfortable. Thank you, Jesus, for saving one man through my message. Thank you, Lord. I'm happy. Praise God. I pray for the grace upon your life to say no. To say no. To say no. Jesus said no when they wanted to make him king. Jesus made Jesus give you the grace. Say no.
Amen.
To any distraction.
Amen.
So you are able to discern and overcome. Discern and overcome. Number two, you are able to step on the challenges. Praise God. What has been a bother becomes a footstool for you. When you see God in the solitude, you are in a position to step on your challenges.
Amen.
Do you know what is disturbing others is what we are stepping on? What is a bother is what we step on.
Amen.
What is bothering others is what we are stepping on, right?
Amen.
Jesus came stepping on the challenges that was challenging Peter, John, James, and the disciples. He walked on the challenge. It is not easy for you to walk over the challenge. Jesus walked on the challenge. The devil sends the challenge to you so that it can finish you. When the devil sees you walking on the challenge, it is one of his worst moments ever in the life of Satan. One of the worst of nightmares was when the devil ruled and saw Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego walking on the challenge. That was the worst of nightmares. For that fire was added 7 times to finish Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. It was not added 7 times to spare them. It was added 7 times to finish them quickly. But when the men of God who had been praying, and their captain Daniel, because we know Daniel prayed 3 times a day, in the solitude alone, he must have taught Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego the power to say no to the king.
Amen.
Was not a joke.
Amen.
They said, no, we will not worship your idols. Because Psalm 16 verses 4, the Bible says, those that seek after gods multiply their sorrows.
Oh, yeah.
When they go to seek witchcraft, they multiply their sorrows, them that seek other gods. When you go to the witch, you multiply your sorrow. There is nowhere the witch will take away your pain. He multiplies your sorrow.
Amen.
So the fire was added 7 times, not because they wanted to spare them, but because they wanted to kill them. But when Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego fell in that fire, the fire burned the chains, and the men stood up on their feet and began walking on the challenge.
Amen.
It is the worst nightmare for Satan to see you stepping on what he said will kill you. May I prophesy to you, you will walk on your challenge.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lift up your hands and say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For the anointing to walk on the challenge. You will walk on the challenges in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We will walk on them.
Amen.
Whatever is the above shall be at once a footstool.
Amen.
Yeah. Everybody saying economy bad, economy bad. That is what we are going to step on to our next level.
Amen.
Because everything that was meant for evil, God turns it for good.
Amen.
To them that love the Lord.
Amen.
We are going to step on our challenges.
Amen.
Peter was greatly challenged by the storms. But Jesus came stepping on the storms.
Oh,
when you spend your time in the solitude, praises, solitude moment with the Lord, you are able to step on your challenge.
Yes.
Yeah, you step on your challenges.
Wow.
And it's like you are very comfortable. It's like you are very comfortable. Have you seen some people who are stepping on the challenge? They seem to be very comfortable.
Yeah.
Vitu zingine unaonekana ingekuwa ni mimi ingeniua. Lakini they are very comfortable. You are shocked. You are very much shocked.
Yes.
The devil hates you as mine.
Yes.
So he sends challenges. So when you laugh,
he wonders
why you are laughing. He expects you to be finished by now.
May you step on the challenges in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Walk on them. That is what Jesus is doing. He is walking on the challenge.
Number three, he runs you to the supernaturals. When you spend time with God in the solitude, God will run you into the supernaturals. Praise the name of Jesus. Look at Jesus. Jesus ventured realms no other personality ever ventured. Because of spending time with God in the solitude, Jesus kept realizing mighty realms and ascending levels no one ever attained. Because Jesus spent all the time in the solitude, he kept ascending levels, and he kept also realizing new realms, attaining new realms in his life. No man ever attained them. Moses never walked on the water. Joshua never walked on the water. Elijah never walked in the water. Jesus walked in the water. That is a miracle reserved for Jesus alone. The only other person who attempted to walk on the waters was Peter. Peter said to him, "If it be thou, Lord, bid me come." Can you bid me to come? And the Bible says, Jesus looked at Peter and said to him, "Come." And Peter, like a dog, stepped out of the boat and began walking on the water. Peter is the second man to ever attempt walking on the water.
Amen.
He's the second man after Jesus. That is why Jesus cannot afford to lose this man called Peter. He had to go to look for Peter. He had to go back to look for Peter. Peter attempted to walk one, two, three. He looked at himself and wondered, wow. Hey, yeah. You know, you must be careful to keep the focus. Peter, aligeuka hivi akaona camera. Wow.
No, just a minute. Usiniambie mimi ndio breaking news leo. Just a minute. Yaani kwani ni mimi ndio breaking news? Kwani mimi leo ndio nini ninaendelea? What is happening? Yaani hata Yesu ananiangalia bila tabia. Yeye. Kwani sasa nimekuwa mkuu wa Yesu ama what is happening? Akaanza kusema.
Mawazo hiyo ni ya kuzamisha mtu. Yeah. Ukianza kufikiria that you are greater than the Lord. Ukianza kujiona. Ukianza kusema nimepata mafuta watanijua sasa. Hapo ndio unaanza kuzama. Kila kitu Mungu anakupatia ili uwe better. Kama hangejiona na hapo na wale watu wanampigia makofi. Peter. Wewe ni Peter anayepata makofi. Makofi shangwe na vigelegele kwa Peter. Peter akazikia. Nimekuwa tu instant popular na hiyo just like that. Yani nimekuwa instant celebrity just like that.
Akaanza kuzama.
My God.
Maana wakati unaweka kiburi ndani unaanza kuzama. Mimi naangalia watu wakizama kwa ministry, naangalia watu wakizama kwa uimbaji, na pia wewe ungeendelea kutukuza Bwana, ungeendelea kuwa mdogo kwa Bwana, angezidi kukuinua.
Mimi nipungue, wewe uongezeke. Mimi nipungue, wewe uongezeke.
Wakati ukitaka kupungua, pungua kabisa, isha. Yesu aonekane. I always feel cold when I stand before the people to preach. Let them not see me, let them see you. Let my mouth become your mouth.
Amen.
Let my hands become your hands. Let my feet become your feet. Let my language become your language.
Yes.
Let everything about you change. Amen. About me change.
Amen.
It's not about me anymore. It's about you, Lord.
Amen.
Let me not speak what you could not speak if you are the one speaking. Ask yourself, if Jesus was the one preaching here, could he talk the way you talk? Could he do the way you do? Could he behave the way you behave? Angejinua vile unajinua. If it was Jesus preaching, angehubiri hivyo na ubiri, ama angehubiri kivyake tofauti na vile na ubiri. Bwana, give me grace. Help me to do your work. Help me to do your work.
Jesus. Help me, Lord. And launch me to the supernatural. The Lord wants to launch you into the supernatural. But you must spend your time with Him.
What is supernatural? More than enough. More than normal. Supernatural world is the world of more than enough. More than normal. More than the app. It is more than normal. It's super. It's super. It's super. And number four. When you spend time in the solitude praises, you are able to reproduce.
Amen.
To reproduce. Reproduce. That's powerful. You can reproduce people of your kind.
Uh-huh.
I want to have many people who can preach the way I preach.
Amen.
I want to have many people who can sing the way I sing.
Amen.
I want to have many people that can do what I do even better. I have no competition with my sons and my daughters. It is ridiculous to fight with your sons. It is ridiculous when you are jealous of your son becoming better than you. You become worse than Idi Amin. You become worse than Hitler. You. If you are competing with your son to be worse than you, if you don't want your daughter to be better than you, you are worse than Hitler. You are worse. You are worse. Wewe na shetani ni the same WhatsApp group. Shetani ndiye hapendi kupitwa. Shetani hapendi upite. Na shetani wewe kwa juu yake. Hawawezi kuwa better than him. But look at Jesus. Jesus said, these things that I've done, you shall do greater and better things than this. Because myself, I'm going back to the Father. Jesus told us that we would do greater things than him. That is Jesus. It is ridiculous when you try to fight with your son. Jesus has no problem with Peter walking on the water like him. He reproduced after his type. When you spend time in solitude with God, you can reproduce after your own kind.
Amen.
You can reproduce after your own kind.
Amen.
You can produce somebody like you. You can raise a singer like you. You can raise a preacher like you. You can raise a prophet like you. There is no problem. The power of reproduction takes place in the solitary place.
Amen.
Peter says, if it be that, bid me come. And Jesus said, come. Jesus has no problem. Yes, Moses, unataka tutoshane. Peter, unataka tutoshane sasa. Hiyo ndio unataka. Umejaa competition. Umejaa vita, Peter. Umejaa nini? Wakati mwingine wanaonaana wanako wakikuja kufanya, they are trying to do what I do here. I don't kill them. I clap for them. Because I know, leo anaweza shindwa. Kesho anaweza shindwa. Kesho kutwa anaweza.
Amen.
Yeah. Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Receive the anointing to reproduce after your own kind.
Amen.
Enter into solitary prison. Begin to call upon the Lord. Begin to speak to Him.
Amen.
And let the Lord give you the grace to reproduce in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Peter walked similar steps with his master, whom he had reproduced himself to. Peter walked the same steps. He was looking at where Jesus was stepping. He would step there. He would step there. And he walked on the water like his master. You are able to reproduce people that can do what you are doing. I want people to pray for the sick here. I want them to carry the anointing to pray for the sick.
Amen.
Then bless them. Let them become greater. We gave one of my coffee. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
We lift up our hands as a church.
Yes.
We can be counted.
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 Yes.
We declare.
Yes.
What do you want to do? Tuna wando wa kuzimu. Tuna wando wa kuzimu. Tuna wangoa. What is it? Shake them now. Shake them now. Anza kutoka na wao. Tuna toka na vijana. Tuna toka na wasichana. Tuna toka na wamama.
The word will never fail. Your word will come to pass. Your word must surely stand. Cause you are God, you're not a man.